One of the main ones is that flame deflector at the bottom of the launch mount. Water begins flowing for that at the T-minus 10-second mark. If we scrub at any point after that, we'll be done for the day, and then teams will need to refill the deflector as well as all of our prop that we use to load on board the vehicle. It's pretty much just under 11 million pounds of prop sitting on that thing right now, and we can actually recycle in about 24 hours now.
Which is incredible given the sheer volume of propellant that is on board the vehicle there on your screen.
All right. Coming up on the 2-minute mark. Again, a lot of ambitious things on the plate for Starship today.
T-minus 2 minutes.
New ship, new year, a lot of upgrades, doing a lot of ambitious things in space this time. Our first payload deploy, relighting a Raptor engine. We're looking good.
So as we mentioned before, we have an opportunity to hold at T-minus 40 seconds, not tracking any issues at the moment that would be necessary right now. So fingers crossed we can pass through that checkpoint without stopping. But the folks on console are continuing to evaluate the launch commit criteria, making sure that the winds are within limits as well as any other weather restrictions. But man, compared to yesterday, this is a textbook gorgeous day.
Oh yeah, little breezy today. But we got clear blue skies for a launch today. So at this point, all the prop has been loaded on the vehicle. We've closed everything out. We're doing our final thrust vector control, our steering for the engine checkouts. Once we hit the 30-second mark, we'll hear the flight director give the final go for launch. So we're under a minute. As we said, we're not expecting a hold at T-minus 40. But do not be shocked if that happens. It has happened in the past, and we can hang out there for a couple of minutes if we need to.
If memory serves me right,
we hold my breath for 4 seconds.
Pass through prop load gate.
All right, we pass right through that prop load gate.
Hot diggity dog.
All right, so we're going to let our flight director, Ty Huntington, take
flight
it away.
Go for launch.
And 20 seconds.
T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We have liftoff.
Vehicle's pitching downrange.
Booster check pressure's not on.
All right, we're more than 30 seconds into flight. Telemetry showing 33 out of 33 engines as it's pitching downrange.
Booster and chip, avionics power and telemetry nominal.
Hearing good call-outs on the ship and booster avionics. You just heard the rumble hitting us about 6 miles away. Watching Starship arc into just endless blue skies right now.
Vehicle supersonic.
More than a minute into flight, the vehicle supersonic.
Max Q.
So we just passed through Max Q. That's the greatest stress the vehicle is going to experience on the way uphill. Reminder that all of our teams down here on the ground are now looking at systems on the tower. They just did a manual check through. That's going to inform that manual flight director's decision. Next moment coming up, though, is going to be hot staging. Don't take your eyes off it. It's one heck of a light show.
What a gorgeous ascent.
Six ship engines getting ready to ignite. That's going to happen while we're still attached.
We can still see the ship's engines from the ground.
Got a little little under 30 seconds away from that. We are hearing good call outs on the tower preparedness from the manual checks. Reminder though, we've still got automated checkouts on the booster and the ship itself. But as of right now, our manual checks and our manual commanding is looking go for a catch.
Booster engine cutoff.
That is incredible news. We just heard the call out for booster engine cutoff.
Engine startup.
Most engines cut off, down to those middle three.
Cruise preference startup.
All right, hot stage confirmed. We've got a booster hopefully on our way back to us, and a ship now making its ascent burn into space. How's it going in Hawthorne, Jesse?
It's great over here. You can hear the crowd screaming for every milestone. The booster is now making its way back down to Earth. Looks like we have 12 of those 13 engines ignited. We're using the engines that actually gimbal.
We are go for booster return.
An excellent call out there. We are go for booster
ship
return.
Ship avionics, power and telemetry nominal.
There's a lot of criteria that needed to line up to ensure that we could have a safe booster catch, and it sounds like we got the go for that. And there you can see on your screen, we had we just jettisoned the hot stage, and there's a great, excellent view there of the hot stage floating away from the super heavy booster. Now we've shut down the engines for that boost back burn. That confirms boost back burn is now complete. That was the first of two burns required for the vehicle to make its way back down to Earth. And next coming up will be the landing burn. That's going to be 13 of those center engines igniting again. And that will then go down to from 13 down to three engines just right before we touch down for that booster catch. Now, reminder, our stage one objectives are to have a controlled ascent, stage separation, as well as a controlled boost back burn and hot stage as well. So we're looking good for that so far. Some great views there from the ship of Earth. That looks incredible. Now, Starship's ship is still firing its engines right now.
Starship trajectory nominal.
And great call-outs. Starship trajectory is nominal. You can follow along the telemetry, the altitude, in the bottom left-hand corner for the super heavy booster, as well as the bottom right-hand corner for the ship. And these views are just amazing. Again, the booster is currently making its way back to the tower today. So we're looking forward to a booster catch with the chopsticks. And in the meantime, you can see those grid fins there helping to control the vehicle and guide it back to its landing site.
Booster FTS is saved.
Now with that, we're gonna hand it back. How's it going over there, Dan and Kate? How are you doing, Kate? Seeing that in person.
Dan had to take that entire segment because I couldn't talk. That was incredible.
There it is.
We can see the booster coming back in now through the plume. At least it looks that way to us. It's incredible that it basically returns. It looks like a speeding, just like this silver flare coming back to the. Once again, we are standing by for attempting to catch the booster at the tower. This would be the second tower catch.
Booster landing
burn. Seeing 13 engines.
Booster now hovering as it aligns with the tower for catch.
Booster coming in. Get ready for that boom, Kate.
Down to three engines.
Booster landing burn shutdown. Megazilla has caught the booster.
Booster You heard it here. Vexilla has caught the booster.
Once again, for the second time, a successful catch by the launch tower. This is the same tower, the launch pad, where that booster took off from just 7.5 minutes ago. Great view from the chopstick arms, looking at those hypersonic grid fins that steer the booster for that precision landing. And it almost looks like it's flapping its wings.
Yeah, you can see just how small that catch fetting is, too, on something that's just so massive.